SQL course, SQL error course, where you come across the concepts of simple thing. So I'm gonna write some of the error codes here, guys. All you need to tell me is whether they'll be in the production or they'll be in the development, or they can be seen in both. The questions are will be on the interview perspective, guys. Okay, the points what I'm listing here will be interview perspective. How the interview questions will come on that, how you need to present your answer. So the SQL code we know is, first one is 0, guys. We know it is successful. 100 you get, then you get minus 104, all the negative numbers, 104, negative minus 104, minus 180, minus 181, and minus 204, 205, 206, minus 305, minus 400, I don't remember much. 500, yes, 501, 2, 3, minus 551, and 678, minus 80, 3 would be the number, minus 805. Minus 811, minus 818, 20, 30, I don't remember anything, minus 904, minus 911, minus 922 or 923, guys, both will be there. Okay, 913, all these things. So these are the SQL codes that you will be coming across in the work experience, in the project, or in your interview experience as well, guys. My point here is, okay, the reason where we see and what is the solution for it, answer that you'll be giving interview purpose. So we know this one, this is very simple, this is a successful query run. Okay, you'll be getting in both production and development areas when you're doing testings, and the reason and solution not required. Okay, not applicable here. This is very simple, guys. One, you say that the row not found when you're running a select query, guys, and you get 100 when you say end of the result set. This is about when you're using cursor. Two cases, guys. Okay, this is also success only, this is also success only, but situation in here, it is successfully saying record not found. Here it is successfully telling that end of the table or end of the case. You see this in the both cases. Okay, you see this in the both cases. No solution application. Okay, not applicable. There is no solution for this, guys. It's not a problem, actually. It's not a problem, so we don't need to provide any solution here. Minus 104 is the syntax errors, guys. Is the syntax errors. Now, where you see here? Will you see it in the test development area or production area? Where you have seen this one? Where can be possibly you are seeing this? Development, when you are preparing the query, guys. Okay, when you are preparing the query for your case, we are not so expert, guys. At the first time only we can write the query properly. We are not that expert. Generally we'll write the query, there will be mistakes of commas or some underscores, hyphens, spelling mistakes, same thing, we'll be correcting them and running it. Okay, in the same thing, same in the production situation also, when you are doing some analysis purpose, okay, analysis purpose, you are doing the query part, then also you may get this one. But the point here is, do not tell this in interview. Do not tell this number in interview. Interview, don't tell that I have got minus 104. He is not at all interested in that number. He is not at all impressed with that number, guys. Okay, forget about this. Come to this fellow. Minus 180 or minus 181. This is related to the errors of invalid formats of date, time, timestamp, guys. We'll be getting here with this one. Now, where can we see? Can we see only in the production, only in the batch? of development area or both? Where can we see? Very fast, guys. We need much time to complete today. So very fast, we need the answer.
Broad.
Both guys, when you're testing also, you'll be getting, but more important is the prod. This is a data issue, guys. This is a data issue. You get, when there is a data problem, you get this -180, -181 cases where you need to remove the or correct the record, remove or correct the row and reprocess. Now in here, guys, okay, this we know, okay, I don't need to tell this point that there is an error with the date and you got it. But that's not the point here. The point is little different in our training, guys. I have a COBOL DB2 program. I have a COBOL DB2 program where the file is acting as input and then there is a table acting as output. That is a COBOL program where there is a table acting as input and a table acting as output. I have a COBOL program where table it is acting as input and then there is a file as output. Okay, so in all three cases we have the table. You people tell me in which of these program style I'll be getting that SQL error.
First two.
In here, guys, if your table is having wrong data date, that's not the possible one, right? In the table you'll not have already the wrong data. In here, table input. So in these both cases, guys, in these both cases you will not get any wrong dates. The date is already in the table, must be valid date. So you are ending up with this single solution, guys, single reason. Now you people tell me where you'll remove or correct the row, in the table or in the file?
In the file.
You got the point, guys? You understood the simpleness, how you need to decode your errors and where from it will be coming from? So in here, correct the data in file, guys. That's how you give the proper solutions. If you say that you'll be removing the row, from where you'll remove? If you're removing the row from the table, guys, table will not have wrong date already. You are inserting, guys. This is an error when you are getting for insert, guys. Insert or update, okay? This is for an error for insert or update. So obviously table is the output. Input is some other program file or something else, but not table. Again, if you are using a table input and giving a table output, in these cases, you will not end up with -180. Because the data in table will be already having a valid date, so why you will be getting error in inserting in another table? This is the concept, guys. Everybody knows what is 180, but only few people know when it will come. Clear? You got the concept why we are training this error codes now? Now, 204, okay, 204 is a table or the object, DB2 object, you see, table, index, everything will come, is not formed. Okay, 4, 5 and 6 are column, not formed. Now, where you see these guys? Where you see them, guys?
There.
Developer only, guys. It's a developer issue, guys, okay? This is a development testing case, you will be seeing them. By giving wrong spelling mistakes while doing the bind, you will get this one directly. So you will not be part of production, guys. This is not part of the production. This is just a knowledge question. Okay, a knowledge question for interview. My point here is, don't tell that I have faced 204 in my production and I solved it. Okay, don't say those things which are very silly and easy catchable, guys. Understand that the intro person know already the answer. The intro person is already knowing the answer and you are giving a wrong answer, he will be easily catching it, guys. Don't take it the intro is not having skill. Okay, even if he has no skill, guys, he is not skilled than us, still he has a question and answer. So he is skillful enough for taking an interview. So there you be your smartness, guys. Which one comes in production, which you should be telling in the interview that I have faced it, I have fixed it, I know that. Some of them are for knowing knowledge purpose, some of them are for fixing purpose, guys. So as such, we have seen so far is only one problem that comes in production to fix, guys. Others are developer mistakes or test scenarios only. Now come to 305. Okay, now this is a very intelligent question, guys. We know that this is a null indicator absent. Indicator absent. We know this. Okay, we know this. Now where will be getting this one? Where will be getting this one? Quickly, guys, I have to complete the whole DB2 today. I need an answer, and wrong or right, fast.
Can be both, Devon, brought.
Can be both, okay. Now, guys, okay, in the interview, if they're asking you that you got minus 305, okay, there are situation, okay, developer situation. He got minus 305. What you have done for the solution? What is the solution he'll be applying, guys? Adding a null indicator to the story. We know this, guys. We know. If you are not knowing this, then you missed our class. That's the only reason that you don't know. But you know it. That means you already have a knowledge without attending the class. Now, in production, guys, production, what is the chance of getting minus 305? What is the chance of getting minus 305 in production, guys?
If we miss that null indicator for any of the column while promoting to production, and we get the null in that field.
Basically, when we are a developer, we will take care about these nulls, right? We know there is a scenario where the nulls will come. We need to add a null indicator. During our testing only, we'll find it. Even if I did not find during my testing, my senior who is reviewing the code, he will check that and point out, right? On a basic standard process, guys, and a standard approach, you will not be having a query without null indicator where the chances of null can appear. I'll repeat my statement, guys. In the project, if there is a query and there is a column with null expectation, the developer must have already defined a null indicator mandatorily. Even, for example, you assume that today, maybe the program is in the production, today you got 305 is very least chance. Even he not use null indicator, even the developer did not use null indicator, the issue might have come long back only, and that might be fixed already. The issue, which is 20 years of experience of that program, not today. When I'm in the support only, you'll get 305. There are support from last 20 years. So they might already seen that issue. They might already fixed it. So you need to go in a prospective that, okay? You need to go in a prospective that you're having a column of null expected, and there will be already a null indicator. Okay, there will be always a null indicator. That is the right answer, because your programs are perfect programs. You cannot blame the program first. Never blame your own COBOL program, guys. Those are the heart of our work at all. That's been coded, tested, reviewed, and has been experience of 20 years of run, and it has been refixed any there, any logical or any concept mistakes. It has been fixed. Today, when I join a project, I'll expect those programs are already running stable and perfect. The only thing that is not perfect is data and the system. The only thing that is keep on changing every day is the data and system. That's not perfect, and the program is perfect. That's the assumption what we go by into a new project. Now in here, guys, in here, if you assume that your program is perfect, will you see minus 305 in the production?
No.
No. But you're gonna see, okay, you're gonna say that in the interview, okay? Now go for a smartness of your answer. Most of my interview, guys, I'll ask this question. Have you seen any 305 in their production? They say yes, okay? Yes, they say. This is not for you guys. I'll delete this after writing. They say yes, and I'll ask them for the solution. I've asked them for the solution. They say that we add a null indicator. We add a null indicator. Now, whose solution is this, guys? Whose solution is this? Is it a support solution or a developer solution?
Developer.
It's a developer solution, guys. Why a support person will do a code change when there is an abandon in front of his eyes? Why a support person will do a code change when there is an issue in front of his eyes? That is the difference of answer for a support interview and a developer interview, guys. When you are going for an interview, make sure you ask the HR that what kind of role they are going to play, what kind of application they can be assigning to you. It's a developer, then the answer is perfectly right. If it is a support role, your answer is completely wrong. I'm going to remove that for your knowledge. Fine. In here, what we do is the append will come, guys. -305 append will come, not the error. Why? If you remember our code, if you go back to our training code, guys, I have written like this. If WS null indicator less than zero, which is a null, I give two options. Either you need to move space or zero. One option I told you. What is the second option I told you? To append the program. To append the program. In which case we append the program? When that particular null column is important for logic. When that particular null column was important for logic, I told you to append the program. So this is, you say production, yes. You got it, guys? Where you are finding this production issue of -305? When you see your process in production, guys, you get an user append there. Okay, when you get a, you'll get an user append on a support day. On a support day, you get a user append saying some U3621, something like this. But when you check your program, you'll be finding the 3921 in the else part of the null indicator. In the null indicator is less than zero. Okay, if the null indicator, indicator is less than zero, there you will be finding this append number 3921. Okay, that's the place where you find. How you fix it, guys? Now let's go for the solution. What is the solution I should do here? Should I use null indicator? It's already there. It's already there, guys. What is the solution I need to do now? I need to correct the data. I need to correct the data. Now you people tell me, okay, you people tell me in which of this case you'll be getting that particular problem. Which of this case you'll be getting that problem?
From table, from table to table and table to file.
In here you'll be getting a chance, in here you'll be getting a chance, guys, because you are getting nulls. Nulls are not present in files. Nulls will be present in a table. So when you are retrieving the null value only, you will be ending up with this story, guys. So you need to fix the data in the table. Earlier, the data fix was in the file, guys. Now the data fix is in the table. Everybody getting the point? Everybody getting the point? There is a scenario, guys. Okay, there is a scenario here, which is very typical situation where you're having input of file plus a table input as well. And then there is some output. Output could be file or a table. We are not interested in that. As we know, 305 will come and there is a table input. Now in here, there's a typical example you can tell in the interview. For each input from file, you are trying to do a fetch or select from table. Okay, for each input of file, which is actual input, your table is acting as a reference, guys. Table is acting as a reference. So for each input of the file, you are fetching the data from a table. In here you got -305 or the append of null. Okay, the append of null means this one. This case is, in this case, solution point, if file is the actual input. If file is your actual input, guys, if file is your actual input, remove the record from file. That will solve the problem. Or if the table is the actual input, table is the actual input, then correct the data. Correct the data. data in the table. That is how the solution is, guys. You understanding this one? Are you following, guys? I know this is little bit completely off the course of COBOL, but you should understand this, because I tell you, no one will put these points in your brain any place. But are you getting this point? Let me ask Vinod. Shiv?
Yes, actually just wanted to know, like, file is actual input, that means we are getting the data from file, then mm-hmm. if you remove the data in the file, then mm-hmm. this issue will be solved.
Yes.
But how to correct the data in the table, like what, like we need to place the space updates, or something?
Run an update query.
Okay.
In my one of the project, these issues that I'm showing you guys.
Understand.
Vinod, you are saying understood, right? Very nice. So the issues and the points which I'm telling you guys, it's only because of my experience only. I'm not giving any assumption stories, guys. There is no such thing called imaginary stories in my training. Whatever experience I had, only those I'll be telling you. If I don't have experience, guys, I generally skip the topic from the training course only, because in my 10 years life, I did not use anywhere or I did not face any issue. But if there is an issue that I faced, which I never expected, then that would be part of your training course already. Could be a developer scenario, or could be your production situation scenario. So what I'm dealing now is the production situation scenario, guys. One of such example, what you will see here is, come down. A 305, okay, a 305, but it's a user append, guys. This I told you in your notepad, it's an user append that caused for a particular query. Okay, you see this query here. It is already having null indicators. Okay, it's already having a null indicator over here, a null indicator over here. It's already having that. So we don't get minus 305, that is for sure. But in the program, guys, if the null indicator is active, that is, if it is less than zero, we are running an append. We are running some append over here. Okay, 3679, append is getting raised. So like I told, you have a couple of situations. One of the situation, your file is the actual input, your table is getting referenced there. Such cases, you don't need to edit the data from the table, correct the data from the file. If required to correct the data from table also, okay, then in our process, okay, in our project, it was having a null for ordered timestamp. There is a mistake on that one. That's the reason why it failed. You see, there is an update query I have ran to put a proper timestamp on that day. It's a business knowledge, guys. Okay. I'm not telling that this is a solution for your project. I'm not telling this is a solution for your project problem. I'm telling that I did a solution for update, being the current timestamp for the day, and I verified it and rerun the process as per the application setup. I have did some production library changes, file changes, did some kind of steps as per the project, which order has to be replaced. All those things I did it in a way which is given in my project part. But yes, solution says to update the value by using a query as well. Shiv, you got the point?
Yes, thank you. I got that.
It's a valid answers, guys. Okay, like I told you, in the interview, you can be very sure with our notepad answers. There is no thing in the notepad as faulty part. We have seen theoretically many points, and we showed that in practical also to make sure everything is good. Same way, whatever I'm typing here is valid answers. When you're going for interviews, you need to make sure that you have a proper hands-on knowledge here, guys. Don't go blindly and then come back and say that I lost an interview. Come on, guys. We are training for last 1.5 months so far, and another 10 days only for clearing interviews easily. Apart from that, working in the project depends on your skills, guys. Okay. As I told you many times, I'm only sharing the knowledge. I'm not sharing the experience to you. Experience will come when you start dealing with the same problems.